Hello guys, today's video is about unboxing and assembling MaxiClimber full body workout. As you see over here, this logo is all about as seen on TV, and nowadays this particular workout is very popular on as seen on TV. It says that burn twice the calories per workout, and it says exercise easily and safely without injuring yourself. And to claim that, it says that no jumping, no impact, no rebounds, anything. It just uses your body weight to create the resistance. As all of us know that our body weight as a form of resistance is one of the most challenging ways to get an effective workout. But unless you have high enough indoor ceilings to support a power tower with pull-up bars, you will struggle to train your back and biceps effectively. And this is one of the reasons why the MaxiClimber is proving so popular. It allows you to engage all major muscle groups using only your body weight. And other things why it is making it popular is because the price is considerably very low than some of the other vertical climbers available in the market. I bought this from Walmart on the Thanksgiving for only $148, and it says that it has compact folding design, it has adjustable heights, built from durable cold roll steel, and it supports up to 240 pounds weight. And it's a kind of a personal workout time. It has a personal workout timer, so you can track your timings also. In addition to that, when I was reading through the material for MaxiClimber, I found that it has compact folding design. It has comfort grip handles, and most important is stable frame design to support 240 pounds person. MaxiClimber themselves recommend relatively short workouts performed more frequently, with sessions as short as 10 minutes each. How frequently you perform this 10 minute session is entirely up to you, but if you start at say 3 times per week and gradually build up 6 times per week, then you should start to get a feel for which frequency you give the best results. So let's open the box. I really doubt that I have to do a lot of assembling in this one, because it says that pre-assembled and easy to store. So let's see that how much assembling is required, but otherwise this is going to be pretty straightforward assembly. I'm going to take the 21 days maxi challenge also, which is, this says that it is inside the box. It says meal plan and interactive training guide. That video is going to be different video, but today's video is all about unboxing and assembling and going through the MaxiClimber. So nothing much inside the box. Some manuals, as I mentioned earlier, how to assemble this MaxiClimber. Then 21 days maxi challenge. Then there is a chart which you can use to track your progress, and this is the main equipment, two supporting handles and support bars. So basically 3 or 4 items which we have to assemble, and some screws and hardware required to assemble all these parts. So going to be straightforward assembly, and let's see what is required to assemble these things. So before starting the assembling, the first step is identifying the parts. Not many parts are there inside the assembly. The first and most important part is the body, which is obviously, this one is the body.
The second one is left and right arm. That is, this is the left and right arm as they are marked over here, left and right. Then the next one is the fixed handles, which are, these are the fixed handles. And next one, large U-bar and small U-bar. So this one is large U-bar and this one is small U-bar. So, and then in addition to that, safety pin. So don't try to search for this safety pin in the hardware bag, because safety pin is already in attached to the main equipment. And then wrench, nut and screws and washers, of course they were in the hardware box. So as per the instructions, it takes only 15 minutes to assemble the entire maxi climber, and the first part of that one is taking the larger U-bar and attaching it to the main assembly. So basically taking this larger U-bar and attaching to the main assembly using the provided screws. First, place the maxi climber like this on the floor, and then take the U-bar, large U-bar, and just pass it on through this groove and tighten it using this provided screws. The way it goes is that basically this screw will go, then the washer and the nut. So I've already tightened this part, and the same thing I have to do now for the small crowbar, small bar. So let me do that, and then we have to assemble the left and right handle. Now change the position of the maxi climber upside down and install the lower U-bar like this. So I have not yet tightened the screws, but once this is done, then we have to loosen this case screw, which is this one, and do the rest of the part, that is this and this part. As I mentioned earlier, loosen this screw. Basically this is already there on the part of the assembly, a part of the body. So remove this screw, take the loosened end of the cable and insert it in this one, and tighten this nut again using the wrench. So once this is done, then we are kind of almost done with the main part of the body. So let me finish this part and then show you the next step. In the next step, basically we have to extend this base with this one and place it on the floor. So we'll cover that in the next step. Now place the maxi bar or maxi climber on the floor and extend this small rod and make sure that it is parallel to the floor, and push this safety pin to make it a stable structure. So this is kind of a maxi climber with, these are the steps on which we are going to keep the legs. But before that, we have to now install this left handle and right handle, which is going to be pretty much straightforward. Setting the right handle and left handle is pretty straightforward. In this particular groove, you have to just insert the handle, and as you see that there is a safety pin. So you just push this safety pin, and as soon as you push, the handle will go down, and it will go down till it comes out from here. See if I can show you. So it will come somewhere here and it will lock. So there are different positions based to adjust the height. So if you're not that taller, you can reduce the height of this entire bar, left and right bar, by pressing this and then pushing the handle again below, so that the upper portion of the handle will remain same.